it sounds like some of these triggers, I mean, they're going to be different for different people, a lot from our own background, childhood, things that just kind of, you know, rub us the wrong way. Do you have any tips for how we can start to notice even those patterns?
So it's a great. So first of all, it's, I use a word for triggers. I call it trigger print. So we have a fingerprint, and it's different. And we all have a trigger print. Some of our triggers are the same. Evolution has taught us, you know, we're falling off a building, we're all going to look afraid. But then, as you say, it is unique to us. It's our childhood, it's our adolescence, it's experiences that happened long ago or experiences that happened 2 weeks ago that in some way are creating a pattern. And that's what we're really looking for. We're looking for this ability to know in certain situations, here's how I tend to react. And part of that, there's two kind of processes I would say. One is to be a little more reflective. So when you've had a really bad day, when you've done behaviors like or said something that you're like, ugh, I wish I hadn't said that, just to kind of, instead of being judgmental, I like to say, put on a scientist coat and say, just be curious, what happened there? What is it that got my goat? Why did I respond? And if you uncover that, more often than not, what you're going to find is a value that was violated. Something that you hold dear that someone got in the way of. And to that is very powerful to know that, because then you'll know in certain situations, I will tend to react in the same way. And once we know that, we then can have tools that we can use in those situations, be it everything from visualizing the power of vision, a different response to the exercise I talked about, a reset, to even kind of slowing things down and just stopping or even walking away from a situation. There's all different options to us, but to have those options is incredibly important.